The French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Stores.
This is roast duck. We're going to serve it with an orange-flavored sauce, canard à l'orange, one of the most famous of all duck recipes. Today on The French Chef. Welcome to The French Chef. I'm Julia Child. Today we're going to do roast duck. We're going to describe how it's done in the oven and we're going to roast it on the spit. This canard à l'orange, or duck with orange, is one of the most famous dishes for duck, and you often get it in a restaurant. But it's not at all difficult to do yourself, because all it is a duck which is roasted and stuffed with a little bit of orange peel, and then you make a sauce and simmer orange peel in that. But what I'm going to show you is the basic method to roast a duck. But before we take up the duck itself, we have to do the orange part. And this part you can do way ahead of time, even the day before you want to serve it. And this consists of making blanched orange peel like that, and you do it this way. You take a vegetable peeler and you peel off just the orange part of the peel. You can't do it with a knife because then you still get some of the white part in. Then after you've peeled that off, you should have four oranges, because you need about that much, which is a good half cup. And then you line it all up and cut it into very thin strips called julienne. You just cut about two or three strips like that and just cut it down like that. And the strip should be about an inch and a half long and about a 1/16 of an inch wide, just as thin as you can make them. And if you have a nice sharp knife and you've practiced all the knife techniques we've shown you, you ought to be able to do this very quickly. And then your orange is like that, and you're going to decorate the duck, with orange segments. But the segments you don't do until the duck is roasting. And the segments look like this. You see, they have no skin on them. But if you do them too far ahead of time, they take on a very stale taste. And so you cut the two ends of the orange off like that, and then just cut down so that you expose the flesh and have cut off all of the white part of the peel. This you have to do carefully, because this is what they call la grande cuisine, or fancy French cooking. And all that means is it just takes more time than ordinary French cooking. Then be sure that you have every little bit of the white off. And then you see the segments are separated by a little piece of filament or skin, so you just cut between them. You can see better after I get this one off. You see, there's your little skin there that you just cut on the other side of that. And there you have your segments. And if there are any little bits of white like that, just cut them off, because this is going to decorate the duck when it's done. And then put them in a bowl and cover the bowl and refrigerate it. And remember not to do it till about half an hour before you serve the duck, or it will be all stale and not taste the way it should. And now for the duck. The most American ducks that you can get, unless you live in an area close to a duck raising place, they're frozen. And the best way to defreeze them, if you have plenty of time, is to leave it in its package and let it defrost in the refrigerator. This sometimes takes 2 or 3 days. And the best alternative, of course, according to the Poultry and Egg National Board, whom I wrote and to find out, is to take it out of its wrapper and put it in a great big basin of water. And then as soon as it's defrozen a little bit, get the legs to move and move the wings. And then as soon as you can reach in and pull out the giblets, do that. And then the duck will defreeze more quickly. And then as soon as it's defrosted and you can feel whether there are any crackles inside, then drain it all out. And you lose much less juice and flavor if you do it that way. And then, after your duck is defrosted, you find some fat in here, which you just pull out and discard, because you can't use duck fat for anything. And then, it's a good idea to take out the wishbone. The wishbone comes right up here and is a little bit above where the breast meat is, and it makes it very difficult to carve if the wishbone is still in. There's part of the wishbone, which I've already taken out. But what you do is to lift this back, and then with a little knife, you see the wishbone in there, and you just cut all around underneath and all around on top. And then when you've loosened it, you just put your finger in and bend it down that way and out. And there it is. And that makes your carving much easier. And then the wings are like that. There's very little flesh on them, and it's best just to cut the wings off. Just take a great big knife and spread the wing out and go whang on each side. And then you save the wings for your stock pot. And now, there's still a little piece of fat in there I'll take out. Now you want to truss the duck. And the French method of trussing is to use a big trussing needle with white string. And if you don't have that, go to the 5- and 10-cent store and get some wooden knitting needles and drill a hole in one end, and then you can put the string in through it. And that works out just as well. I don't know why you can't find trussing needles here, but you can. Now, you want to truss the wings to the body. And we've got a little more neck here than we need, so we just cut it off. And that can be saved for stock. And then you just take your needle and go right through the carcass. This doesn't hurt the duck at all. I think a trussing needle is much easier than those skewers that you have, and besides, they don't stick into you. And then turn the duck on its back and bring that neck skin up over, and then just go right through there to catch the neck skin and catch a little bit of the back. And then come through the other end. And then tie. And give the string, there's one twist, give it another twist. And then tie it and then twist it again around that way so the knot won't loosen as you're tying the final knot. So there's that part all done. And then we're going to fill it with the orange peel. Going to use about a third of it, and some salt, about half a teaspoon of salt. We'll just lift up the duck and put the salt in. And then, though you don't have to, I always think a little bit of onion is good. And just cut it fairly finely. Actually find that the bigger the knife, the easier things are to do. And that goes inside. It's really actually better not to do any more of a stuffing than sort of a flavor stuffing like this. Then I'm going to put in a little bit of sage. You don't have to have any sage at all. That's about half a teaspoon, and rub it all around. And then we're going to close the opening. So take the tail part and give it a bend like that to break it a little bit, and fold that over, and then go right through, and that holds the legs in place. You don't have to go through the legs again, you just tie them again the same way. This is particularly important to truss the duck if you're going to do it on a spit, because you can't have it flapping around. And besides, it looks much better when you serve it if it's been held in place. Then, because ducks are very fat, and particularly American ducks, I don't know why we have this, only this one breed, the Peking, because the French duck, they have a Nantes duck, and they have the Rouen duck, and they're much less fatty, and I think they have a bigger breast. But to get rid of the fat, you take a sharp-pointed instrument and just poke it through the skin all around where the fat is. Don't poke up over the breast here. The fat lies down along there and under the second joints and along the back. And just poke it at half-inch intervals. And then as it roasts, these little fat holes allow the fat to escape. See, there's a lot of fat right up, particularly right around in there. You don't want to really go through to the flesh. It's just pricking the skin. So there, that's all ready to go. And then you have, with your duck, you have the neck, which I have already hacked up. And you have your two pieces of gizzard. And for some reason, this duck had three livers in it. The one I had the other day didn't have any liver at all, so we were lucky. And that you can use to make the stock for your sauce. And as you remember, when we made the lamb stock, it's very simple to do. You dry these off, and then you brown them in very hot fat with a cut onion and a cut carrot. And then when they're browned, you put them into a saucepan and cover with water or water and stock. You can use a bit of canned beef bouillon, about half and half, to give it a good flavor, and then let it simmer quietly for 2 hours and strain it and degrease it, and the base for your sauce is all ready. That's just what I've done with this. That's about 2 cups of strained, degreased, good, strong, beautifully flavored duck stock. And once that you have it all flavored up, the making of your sauce will just take you about 3 minutes. So, the wings you would also add. You just go whack. There. And then, our duck is now ready to go. We're going to do this on a spit. And if you're thinking of getting a new oven, be sure to get one with a rotary spit, because they're just wonderful for duck and turkey. There's just something about having it rolling around and basting itself. And now, with the spit, you want to put it in from the neck end so that you'll be able to lift the duck up and drain it. If you had it the other way around, you'd have to drain it this way, which wouldn't work at all. So remember, start at the neck end and you just pierce right through it. And then be sure that you get it anchored into the shoulder muscles there. It's sometimes a little hard to do, but you just push it in. There. Because when the duck is going around on the spit, you want it to... Well, I got that in too soon, so I didn't get through the back part. There. It's got to go through the tail piece here, and I'll have to anchor it in there. There. And then for the lower prong, I always have to do this with all kinds of noises. There. Now get that anchored into part of the carcass so that when the duck goes around, it will be fairly firmly anchored. That's why they have these prongs. So now that's all ready to roast. And it doesn't need any basting or anything like that because it has plenty of fat. And so we put it into our rotisserie. The sticks goes in there. Turn the heat on to high and turn on the spit. And then you don't have to do anything to it. Now this is a 4.5-pound duck and it will take about 1.25 hours. And if it's in the oven, which I'll show you, you put the door on. There, that's all you have to do. Now if it's in the oven like this one here, actually, oven roasting has its charms, too, because you get all these juices in the bottom. You start with your oven at 450 and start with the duck over on its side like that and let it brown for about 5 minutes, then turn the duck onto the other side and let it brown for about 5 minutes, and then on its back for about 5 minutes. This will take 15 to 20 minutes, and then turn your oven down to 350 and roast it for about a third of the time on its side, and then turn and roast it for a third of the time on its other side, and then for the last 10 minutes roast it on its breast and salt it. In this way you'll get a much more even browning and the breast will be tender. Now this is all done and I have the oven on it warm, which is not very hot, and so that will keep very nicely. And now, when your duck is roasting, we're now going to do the sauce, which is the final fixing of it. And this recipe for duck à l'orange is a brown duck stock, and then it has a sweet and sour coloring of caramel and vinegar, and then it has the orange peel which simmers in it. So we're now going to do the caramel. And with that, we're going to have 3 tablespoons of sugar. That goes right into your little pan. And then we're going to have 1/4 cup of red wine vinegar. And whenever you're doing a caramel, shake the pan, swirl the pan until the sugar has dissolved. Because if you let it boil before the sugar has dissolved, very often it will crystallize. And so keep taking a look at the pan and seeing whether it has crystallized, whether the sugar is melted. And as soon as it has, then it can boil hard. And now we're going to do the thickening of our sauce. This is our duck stock here. And we're going to thicken it with arrowroot. Now, arrowroot is a starch of perfectly a white powder, which is very much like cornstarch, but the difference is that when it is in a sauce for thickening, the sauce doesn't become slightly cloudy, it remains clear. And for certain fancy sauces like this orange sauce, or for a ham with Madeira sauce, you thicken with arrowroot. It's rather difficult to find. I had to go to several places to find this. Sometimes they have it in drugstores, and other times at fancy grocery stores. If you can't find it, use cornstarch, and you use it exactly the same way. And we have about 2 cups of sauce here, so we'll use about 2.5 tablespoons of arrowroot. You can always add a little bit more if you don't have enough. And then we're going to flavor it with port wine. And if you use port wine, be sure and get one that's not sweet. What you want is the flavor of it. And then beat that up with a little wire whip. We get all the lumps out. And keep your eye on your caramel. There it is. It's just boiling up. When the bubbles get thick, you can tell that it's just about caramelized. So after you've mixed this up into your sauce here, you just pour it in to your stock, and then add your orange peel. That's about 1/3 cup now of orange peel, and that's to simmer slowly, and that picks up flavor. So I'll let it simmer over here. Now I'm still watching this caramel. It isn't ready yet, so I can get out the duck, because we still have the final flavorings of the duck to do. Get our serving platter too. Now, see, that's nice and brown. But what you want to be very careful when you're cooking the duck is that you don't overcook it. On the package that this duck came in, it said cook it about 3 hours, and that's crazy. I don't know what you get. You just got a piece of dry straw, I think. Now, to tell when the duck is done, you lift it up and let the juices drain out of it. And when the last juices can be very faintly rosy, because in France they often serve it medium rare. And also, when you press the drumsticks, they're tender and they move in their sockets. And then we remove the trussing strings. You just cut them and pull them out. There's the knot. Cut by the knot, and then it pulls out more easily. And there you are. Now we want to look at our caramel again. See, those bubbles are getting a little bit thicker. When they get to be great big bubbles, you can tell how it is. Now look again at our sauce. And we just want that to simmer slowly. You can see that's taken on a very light thickening, and that's all you want it to do. And now back to our duck pan. Now you see with this, doing it in the roasting pan, you get all these nice juices down in the bottom of the pan. And I always put a cut up carrot and onion in after the duck has browned for its 15 minutes. Now I've got to go back to our caramel. We keep jumping. Now you see, that's just about done. And so with caramel, you just have to keep watching it, because if it burns, you just have to start and do it all over again. You notice how thick those bubbles are. Just let it go for half a minute more, and then take it off the heat and pour in a little bit of your warm sauce, because you have to dissolve the caramel. And then put it again over heat, so that you can tell whether you've dissolved the caramel, if there are any little bits of the caramel in the bottom of it, which there aren't. So then you pour it back into your sauce, and you're all done. So that can just stay warm now, and then we're going to deglaze all these juices in the roasting pan. We've gotten the fat off now. And a little bit of some carrot and onion give added flavor to your sauce. Then we want to... No, I think I'll deglaze that with some port, because it's nice to have a little wine flavoring in. I'm going to put in about a quarter of a cup of port. You can put in even more if you want. And deglazing means only just stirring up the roasting pan with a liquid until you've dissolved all of the nice flavorful brown bits. That's one of the very important parts in French cooking, that you always deglaze, because that's where you have extra flavor. And then you want to let that reduce. It's terrible to have a sauce that has an alcohol raw taste in it. So anytime you put in port, brandy, wine, or anything else, you'll always let it boil down about half, because all you want is the flavor. So there's no alcohol left in it at all. And now this, we will now strain this into our sauce, and that will give it even additional flavor. Just pour it right in. There. See that? The carrot and onion has always also given it more flavor. Now, we'll just taste the sauce. You see, it's a very, very slight thickening. That's very good, because all of the orange peel has simmered long enough in it to make it delicious. So we will now decorate the duck with our orange peel. Now this you have had in the ice box and have only done about half an hour before serving. So you just lay segments across the duck like that. Orange and duck go awfully well together, because the dark, rich duck meat and the fresh taste of fresh oranges is just an awfully nice combination. If oranges happen to be out of season, you can use fresh cherries or canned Bing cherries, which you just warm for a little bit in the sauce. Or you can use fresh peaches, which you can poach in the sauce. I'm going to put a little bit of watercress on there. And then you simply just put the rest of the orange segments around. Use your fingers. It's awfully hard to do it with spoons. And if you're well scrubbed up, you never need to worry. Then spoon a little bit of sauce with peel over the duck and the oranges, which makes it glisten. You can see why it's nice to have the arrowroot, because it makes a clear sauce. I must say that smells good. Then your duck's ready to serve, which you can and should really improve your sauce a little bit more by putting some butter into it. Now, you'll say that your sauce has just been at the simmer, so you take it off the simmer and put in about a tablespoon of butter and swirl it into the sauce. This is called buttering a sauce, and it's something that they always do in French cooking. And it's not very often done in American cooking, but that's what gives that sauce that sort of lovely, velvety taste. And then when that's absorbed, you can put in about 2 tablespoons of butter if you like, and then pour it into a saucepan. A warm sauce bowl is what I mean. Now, when you're serving this famous dish, you don't want to muss it up with a lot of vegetables. This should be a separate course. You'd serve with it just potatoes, either potato chips or home-fried potatoes or sautéed potatoes and bread. And then you could have a fish or consommé for a first course, and then you could follow your duck with salad and cheese. But these are such special tastes that it's too bad to hurt them with any other extraneous matter. Now, duck is not very easy to carve if you're not used to it. And the thing to do is to outline with your knife the legs and second joints, and then take your fork and bend it all the way back, and that loosens the ball joint from under there in the back. And then, to carve the breast, you cut right down one side of the breastbone, and then take your knife and make thin slices all along there. And you don't take your wing off until the end. There's very little meat on it anyway. I'm not going to carve it now, because we're going to do it another time when we do our pâtés and aspics. And with this, you have 3 choices, either a white Burgundy or a Sauterne or a red Bordeaux. And remember, don't overcook the duck. 1 1/4 hours for a 4.5-pound duck is sufficient. Now, next time we're going to do French chocolate mousse, a perfectly delicious no-cal dessert, as we laughingly say. Well, that's all for today on The French Chef. This is Julia Child. Bon appétit.
Julia Child is co-author of the book Mastering the Art of French Cooking. French Chef is made possible by a grant from Safeway Stores.